Hi, I'm Eric D'Amato, and welcome back to Let's Play The Wolf Among Us. Going to the butcher shop now. Cut above. Butcher shop, Tubman Street. Afternoon.
He's got a whole lot of customers, or he doesn't have any.
Probably the latter.
Right. Not very appetizing. Frozen solid. Who'd want to eat this? Wolf?
Well, welcome, Sheriff. What can I get for you? You interested in a particular cut? let's see. What do we have in stock? Let's see what we got here. Flank steak on special. New York strip. Oh, I can have some wild boar in tomorrow, if you like. Sirloin...
I know Bloody Mary hangs around here. I want to talk to her.
I don't know what you mean. What you see is what you get. Just meat. You'll find anything else.
I don't believe
we just... We do more wholesale and meat packing than walk-up service. I'd like to help you. Really, I would. But there's nothing here.
So you don't mind if I take a look around?
I guess not. Sheriff, I... Did you hear that?
What?
Oh, I'm real sorry. Hold on. I just gotta go check on that. Don't go anywhere. I'll be right back.
Butcher?
I just have to go see. Shit.
Meat locker.
I got it covered back here, Sheriff. I'll be right out.
What's the problem? I'm just coming back to give you a hand.
I'm sorry, Sheriff, but you're not supposed to be back here for safety purposes. Come on, damn it.
For such an innocent guy, you're acting pretty damn strange, Johan.
I don't know what to tell you. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. They're gonna kill me. Oh, God, she is gonna fucking kill me. He's gonna get me killed.
Sticky asshole, Bruce.
How you doing?
Please, Bigby. Please don't.
Bigby? What happened to Sheriff?
Please don't kill me, Sheriff. I don't want to die. Please don't kill me.
Listen. Just calm the fuck down, okay? I just want some answers.
Okay. I'm dead. Either way, they said to me, Johan, you could keep your life and lose your shop, or lose both. What would you do? It was a simple choice to make in the moment. Easy, even when they got you on a hook in the deep freeze.
They? Do you mean Mary? Bloody Mary?
This isn't my shop anymore. That crew took it from me a long time ago.
Crew?
Fuck. the Crooked Man's people. Jersey Devil, Dean Dumb, and that mental case Bloody Mary. You want to talk about the real butcher? It's her, not me. This is her place. I'm telling you, they muscled in on me, took over my storage and delivery a long time ago.
All cause of that heat wave. That summer was even hotter than this one. Oh, I let Mary and those porkers stay cool in the meat locker one day, playing cards, having a great time. I guess they were sizing the place up. Shows what I get for being nice. I'm just a victim in this. I don't know what they do back there. I swear.
It's all right. I believe you. Calm down.
I knew this would happen. Didn't know when, but there would be the day. Big... Shh.
Let's take the door down. Or up, rather. What have we here? A lab of some sort.
Is this place?
I told you, Bigby. I don't know. They muscled me out. I swear, I don't know anything more. I haven't been back here when it was like this.
Warning lights.
It's business. It's all I've ever had. I guess that's why I stuck around when they took it.
These lights, Johan. Did you warn them I was here?
I had to. You come in here making trouble for me. But you only give a shit now because the Crooked Man stepped on your toes or something. Where were you when they took this place from me? It hasn't been easy for me. You think I want to live with this at my back?
Well, I'm here now. I'm gonna sort this all out.
That's where the glamours are coming from.
So this is what Beast was delivering. Glamours, other kinds of magic. Could be dangerous stuff.
Shackles.
Chains. Who's getting chained up here?
You can't think I'm the only one the Crooked Man has under his yoke.
These are raw materials for making magic. Anti-Greenleaf and any other rogue witches out there probably get their supplies here. That symbol, it's on all the packages. What is it?
That's the Crooked Man's brand. It's on everything that goes in and out of here.
So you do know something, huh? Is that a wheel or what?
I guess they never used that thing on wolves, huh?
What's that supposed to mean?
It's from back in the homelands. A torture device. It came over here with the rest of our stories. Not that Mundys need any help coming up with that kind of thing. It makes people crooked. By breaking their bones and... Do I really need to explain this? Maybe just don't touch anything back here, please.
Hello.
Huh. Looks like math or something. Everybody on here? Do you know anything about this?
I don't know. A lot of fables out there need a lot of things.
Don't you see what's going on here? All these fables get magic from him. Business is booming. He's got all he needs. The raw materials and the slave labor to process them. And with all this gear, looks like they could make just about any kind of magic. A lot of it. And it's pretty clear why.
Oh yeah? Why?
Doing it like this, it's bound to be cheaper than the 13th floor.
This is just horrible. Things that must have gone on here.
It's the Pudding and Pie girls with the ribbons. Whoever he's got in here in these chains, he's enslaving fables. My watch. People just don't know the real cost of getting something cheap.
You don't have to tell me.
That fucker Crane knew all about it.
Yeah, what about Crane? If this all... I mean, finding the crooked man is so fucking important, why don't you ask your boss?
Snow?
No, Crane. He said he knows where everybody is. I don't know how, but he's got some way. That's right. It was that creepy magic mirror with the big green head and all. Why don't you just use that? Find the crooked man that way. Leave me alone. Yeah, with stuff like that mirror, I'm surprised that you ever need to leave the office.
Crane shattered the mirror and made off with one of the pieces. Probably still has the shard with him.
Well, if they got their hands on an important magical item, there's only one place they'd take it.
Where? Lucky Pawn.
The Lucky Pawn. They probably took Crane there, too.
The Lucky Pawn. If I can find the mirror piece there, I can find the Crooked Man.
Hey, hold on. Well, I'm real happy you found what you're looking for, Bigby. But what about me? Huh? What the hell am I supposed to do now? I'm gonna have to spend the rest of my short life looking over my shoulder for Bloody Mary.
Report to the business office. Tell Snow I sent you there, and we'll figure something out. Some kind of protection.
Thank you. Thank you, Sheriff.
Jersey, don't give me that shit. What the fuck is the point of having a system if you're just gonna...
my fucking
Jack,
system.
What the fuck is going on?
But you...
I'm,
the guy who
just
makes
gonna...
Sure.
I'm the guy to keep shit in order. You know. And that's it, Woody. If you love your ex so fucking much, why'd you pawn it in the first fucking place, huh?
I didn't pawn it, asshole. It was stolen.
So get the fuck out of my sight. Hit the bricks. See you later.
Hey. What's going on here?
What the fucking hell?
Christ. And this fucking guy too?
Are you kidding me? It was here. It was right fucking here. What did you do with it?
How the fuck do I know?
Listen, you bald little dipshit. You're gonna
be bald too, dude.
You piece of shit.
Back it up, Jersey. You're dealing with me now.
You got here fast. Still looking for whoever killed them hookers? Or are you done chasing your tail?
Where's my axe? Who'd you give it to?
You follow me here all the way from Battery fucking Park? That's it?
Back off, dog. I just want what's mine. My axe.
You talk big. But I don't think you got the stones to back it up. Still a little sore, are we? Why should Mary get all the fun? You ain't so tough. This ain't gonna go like... You fucking motherfucker! Oh, motherfucker!
Oh. Ooh.
What the hell are you doing? This is my fucking fight.
Not now.
Dog, you got a lot of nerve.
Crap.
Whoa.
Go on! Try to stop me!
Fucking stay down! There she is!
Taking this out for off, dude.
Magic Mirror's missing shard. Where is it? Bloody Mary brought it here, didn't she?
You don't know anything about anything, do you? What do you have? Nothing. Had useless bitch Snow White in a broken fucking mirror. No fucking friends.
Oh! The next thing you say better be something useful.
You can't find a crooked man. No one can. Oh, the door to his house. It bounces around. Never in one spot. You'll never find it. Even Crane had to use the magic mirror. They dumped all his shit here. Bloody Mary uses this place like a fucking dump.
Where's Crane's stuff? Where'd they put it?
In back. Just go on. Get Crane's shit and go. Not that it's gonna do you any good.
See anything?
Crane's coat.
Is it in this pocket?
No time for traveler's checks, huh? He won't be needing this anymore.
One is in here.
That sick piece of...
Pocket.
The shard. It's the shard. Finally.
Wrong size. It's half the shard.
Hey, Sheriff. Those girls are still dead. Oh, and there's nothing you could do to bring them back. And I don't know what they did, but I do know this. Oh, if they're dead, it's because the crooked man wanted them dead. That's all it takes. So you can roar smash the place up. Shit, you can wail on me all you want, but what good is it gonna do you? Because he ain't in your town. You're in his, and he sure as shit is ready for you.
Out of smoke?
Oh, come on, we should offer him one. There we go.
Thanks. Shitty brand.
You're welcome.
I'm not gonna lie. I was having trouble deciding which one of you to hit with this thing. Jersey was wrong, you know.
About what?
About those girls. There is something you can do about it. You can get the fucker who did it. Ain't that the plan?
Yeah, you're damn right it is.
All right, go do it then.
Hey, Woody.
Yeah?
You gonna be all right?
You know me.
I hope he's okay. Business office, the woman will come evening.
I don't care who killed the prostitutes. If Crane was helping himself to the community coffers, it means his hand was in my pocket, and you just let him go!
I don't know what you heard, but it didn't happen like that.
Are you denying the facts?
She's denying me the chance to get a word in. Now, Miss White,
I... Sheriff Bigby has returned.
Ah, there's the old wrecking ball himself.
Bigby, where have you been?
I'm not finished here, Miss White.
You will have to wait. Just one moment. Please.
I do not trust Bluebeard.
Look what I found.
Seems your dog wants a biscuit.
I'm not in the mood. And you've got a lot to answer for.
Oh, really?
Bufkin, get this piece in the mirror right away.
With pleasure, Miss White.
Finally, things are swinging back in the right direction. Good work, Bigby. You've been gone all day. What did you uncover? I thought you were going to report back to me. I mean, it's fine.
I had to get real persuasive with the Jersey Devil down at the Lucky Pawn, but he told me that the Crooked Man's door, to wherever it is he hangs his hat, it moves. It's some kind of magic door.
Do you think the mirror will be able to find the door, once it's fixed?
That's how Crane did it. And that's how we're gonna do it.
Excellent work. Really.
Sheriff, I could use your assistance. Would you join me at the mirror?
Don't go far, Sheriff. I'd like to have a few words of my own with you.
Why the hell did you burn Crane's stuff, huh? Don't bullshit me. Bufkin was there. I know it was you.
Given Ichabod's obsession with Miss White, I thought it best to make sure that nothing untoward saw the light of day.
Oh, fuck off. I know you were burning evidence.
Then tell me, what evidence did I burn?
I have more important things to deal with right now, but you can be sure that we're gonna have a long fucking talk about this when I'm done.
I do so enjoy our talks. I'll wait with bated breath.
Shut up, Bluebeard.
I don't understand. This piece just doesn't want to join the rest. Do you have any idea why?
Got me.
Not necessarily. Well, where did you find it? What has it gone through since being separated from the rest? Shattering is a very traumatic experience, you know. So this process can be a little touchy.
I found it in Crane's coat. Last person I saw with Crane or his coat was that psycho Bloody Mary. Maybe she had some...
Ah, yes, Miss White was asking about her. That explains it. You know who and the mirror have a very unhappy history with each other. How would you like it if she tried to use you as a doorway?
I think I already know the feeling.
Well, I think I know how to proceed now. It will just take a little extra coaxing, that's all. Thank you for your help.
You weren't Sheriff.
It could be a while, Sheriff. I'll find you when it's ready. Besides which, he might not want to come out with you watching.
Oh, he doesn't like being spied on.
If you ask me, you're everything that's wrong with Fabletown.
Is it fixed? Did you ask about the Crooked Man?
Bufkin's still working on it. He said it might be a while.
If you're so self-reliant, what do you want from the business office so bad?
What I want is my business.
I can't take those two right now. We're trying to catch a murderer, and they're over there bickering about bureaucracy. We're at war. Don't they realize that?
You need some help over there.
Yeah, thanks. Go talk to Toad. But just so you know, we can't pay him. He really needs to go to the farm, you know. So, just break the news and be done with it, okay?
No budge on that bloody glamour. I only came in to see him.
Miss Toad, come here.
I thought I made myself very clear.
I see how it is. Passed off to an underling, eh?
Why am I not surprised?
Well, you did cause what damage brings me in here, so maybe it's for the best. Just need a little bit of dosh to cover it. I tried talking to her about it, but it's like chatting up a brick wall, it is. Now, I'm sure you've got your own agenda, Sheriff, but I've taken a real wallet because of you.
Before we get into any of that, what do you know about the Crooked Man?
Don't try to change a subject on me. I need a little bit of that walking around money, you know? My car, total, the gaping mall in my wall. Any of us sound familiar? I'm not looking for a handout. If you're waiting
for me to volunteer. Here, Crane won't be getting any use out of this. Will that do?
Crane's money, eh? Well, I suppose that means it belongs to me as much as anybody. Thank you, Sheriff.
Use it to get glamoured, Toad. You got the money now, so I won't be so lenient if I catch you again. And the farm is always on the table.
But of course.
Bluebeard. You want to talk? Now's your chance.
I've just made my donation funding this office, so direct your questions to Miss White.
Bastard.
Well, at least he's not trying to get rid of me.
He's not?
For now. Did you take care of Toad? I mean, I saw the way he left. I know it may not seem that important right now, but glamours are the law for a very good reason. You know that as well as anyone.
Don't worry. I did the right thing.
Are you sure? Because he left looking pretty happy. Fine, we'll deal with it later. I know I should be asking how it got like this, but I just keep wondering why it happened. To Faith and Lily. You've seen his world. Do you have any idea why he'd want them dead? I don't know if the Crooked Man killed them with his own hand or if it was one of his goons, but someone did.
If there's one thing I've figured out, it's that the Crooked Man is all about control. It's what he does with the loans at the pawn shop. The magic he peddles. Chains. Ribbons. Maybe Faith and Lily weren't doing what they were told. Or maybe they just tried to leave.
Sheriff! Miss White! I believe the mirror is repaired.
Oh, good.
I have to say, I have been better. But thanks for putting me back together.
I'm sorry, I have to know. Mirror, mirror, we're glad you weren't slain. Now please show us that sick creep Crane.
He's dead, isn't he?
Yeah, I want to see where he's ended up to.
You will get on that plane to Paris, and you will wait for the day the Crooked Man needs you. Until then, not a peep. Otherwise, I get to deal with you my way. So please, please disobey. Wait a minute. Someone's watching.
What just happened?
We pointed you in the wrong direction. Looked at Bloody Mary's reflection.
Oh, her. That explains the sting. I'd rather not have to feel the pain she brings. So, let's not do that again, okay?
Fair enough.
Looks like we'll have to track him down later.
You're right. We need to focus on the immediate threat, and that's the Crooked Man. Bigby, we don't have a lot of time.
Are you having trouble with the rhyme, Sheriff?
Just show me where I can find the Crooked Man.
I haven't been feeling well of late. Seems neither of us can cooperate.
Damn.
Perhaps I can be of assistance? Mirror, mirror, keep us sane. Show the door to Crooked Man's domain.
I can always count on you, Bufkin.
Thanks, Bufkin.
I don't recognize the door, but that's the Crooked Man symbol on it.
Hold on.
The door. It moves.
What'd I tell you?
Wait a minute. I know that door.
That's Central Park. I don't know when it's gonna move again, but I'm gonna get there before it does.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial. This can't be like it was with Tweedledum. I don't care if it gets out of hand. You don't let it come to that. I know that emotions can run high, and you have your reasons to handle this a certain way.
I can't make that promise. This could turn sour, just depending on how the wind blows. I have to be able to handle it how I see fit.
If people are going to have faith in the Fabletown government again, we need to be fair. Show them that we're doing things the right way. I have enough to worry about here while I prepare the case against him. So I'm going to trust you to handle this properly. That is, if you think you're ready.
Of course I'm ready. I got no other choice.
Well, we're going up to see the Crooked Man now. We found his location, and we're at the Gothic Bridge, Central Park 94th Street. Night. Hope we get the bastard. Still there. Perfect. I feel it's a trap. We're in the Crooked House now.
Tim, what the hell are you doing here?
Good evening, Sheriff. I'm here to take you to the boss. Thanks, by the way, for leaving off Tiny.
No reason to be
I have to admit, when they asked me to watch the door, I wasn't sure what to expect when you came through that portal.
Hold on. You've just been waiting for me to show up?
That's a trap.
You knew I was coming?
This is a trap.
That's what they told me. I don't know, they said you made it pretty clear. I'm supposed to bring you right on in, so if you'll come this way. Look, this is the one thing I have to do.
Fine, lead on.
The wheel, the old torture wheel. Oh. This might be a short episode because it's the end of.
Thanks for understanding. This is all I'm here to do, and I don't want to mess it up. I know I'm probably the last person you'd expect to be a guard.
You shouldn't be here, Tim. This place is dangerous, especially for someone like you.
It's not like that. Whatever you may think of him, he doesn't treat me like some broken little kid. I think he gets what it's like. He gave me a job, and I'm lucky to have it. This is the only option I've got. Just keep that in mind, maybe? Because if you and the boss go up against each other, the rest of Fabletown is gonna get caught in the middle. And if you're here, it can't be good.
I can find the door myself. You should just get the hell out of here. Things are gonna get ugly in a minute.
Leave? I told you, I have to do this.
Hey, you've been warned. Stick around, and you're a part of this, just like anyone else.
A lot of us depend on him. Some of us never get to the front of the line at the business office. But he's there. We need you, but we need him too. What we don't need is a war.
Tough.
Hey, Sheriff, hold up. I gotta go in with you. Thanks.
Am I some kind of a fucking joke to you? What did I tell you, eh? Stop laughing at me.
Oh, yeah?
Mate, give me some breathing room, will ya?
He's the wolf.
Sorry.
I got a problem.
You needn't worry. He'll come around.
Bloody hell!
This fucking guy!
crooked man.
I was wondering when you'd turn up.
I'm sorry, sir. He wouldn't let
me. It's all right, Tim. I shouldn't have expected the sheriff to give you respect enough to do your job. But you did fine. You can go now.
Crooked man.
You see, everyone in Fabletown has a role to fill. You just have to pay attention to what they need to help them find it. Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
It's gonna be shorter than I thought, I guess. Well, sorry about that.
I've heard stories about you.
Bloody Mary.
In the old days, how you picked off those men one by one. Oh, how they screamed. The wolf is coming. And they would wait, hiding anywhere they could squeeze their pathetic, shivering corpses. Some would just drop to their knees where they stood, close their eyes, and wait for death. And you'd give it to them. I wish I could have seen it. Oh well.
Did you send Colin to the farm? Us and 85.5% of players decide Colin should not go to the farm. Did you attempt to remove Narissa's ribbon? Us and 36.2% of players decide to remove the ribbon. Us and 63.2% of players went to the cut above first. Us and 73.3% of players decided Toad should not go to the farm. And 43.7% of players lit a cigarette in response to the Crooked Man. It seems a lot of people tend to do this. Anyway, next time we'll be starting up the final episode of Wolf Among Us. And until then, well, till next time. Hi, thanks for watching. This has been played and recorded by me, Merrick D'Amato. The art was by Rafaela Agrona, and you can find a link to her commission page in the description below. See you next time.